What's up guys, welcome to our channel Etechniz. In this video we will talk about how to control bandwidth on tplink router, or if you're looking to control a bandwidth of a wi-fi user who is connected to your wi-fi network, then this video is for you. So watch the complete video. Now let's talk about all the steps you have to use. Simply open the browser, do a right click and open it. Type the IP address in here, 192.168.0.1. Afterwards, type the password. You can use the default password, or if you have set up a password, type that in. You can let me know in the comment section if you want to know the default password for tplink router. Afterward, you have to click on DHCP options, and here you have to click on this DHCP clients list. And once you'll be here, you will see the devices connected to your Wi-Fi, and we're gonna perform this bandwidth control on this Windows 11 PC. So let me show you the speed. Let me do a speed test. Let me perform it on Bing and let's start it. You can see that I have a good speed, not that good, but works fine for me, 90 Mbps, and same goes for the upload as well. So we're gonna perform a bandwidth control for this Windows 11 PC. So here we have a MAC address. Simply copy this MAC address and click on address reservation, and once you'll click on it, click on add new and type, or either paste it, the MAC address, and we have 192.168.0.100 already for this Windows 11 PC. Here you can see that, and we have to do the same thing in here. We have to type the same one as it's already connected to our Wi-Fi network. Simply click on this save. Once you'll do that, you can see that it's assigned with 192.168.0.100, the local IP address. Afterward, click on bandwidth control, and here in download and upload bandwidth speed, you have to type this numbers. If you have 100 Mbps of speed, it's completely up to you. You can type that in here, and you have to multiply the speed with 1024 is a number you have to use to multiply the speed. If you have 200 Mbps of speed, then you have to multiply that 200 with 1024 and you will get the answer. So type that in here. After that, check this box, enable bandwidth control, click on save. Once you'll do that, click on this add new, and here you need to type the IP range. You need to type the same one, 192.168.0.100, and afterward you can see all the configuration in here. If you leave this one blank, it works fine. And afterwards you need to assign the minimum download speed and the maximum download speed, and the minimum download speed and the maximum download speed. So let me make it 1 Mbps and the maximum to 5120, which is already multiplied with the 1024 and the 5 Mbps of speed in here. And I'm gonna put the same one, 1024, in here. When it multiplied with 5 Mbps, then this number comes up, 5120. Click on save, and here you can see that this device has the bandwidth limit now till 5 Mbps. So now let's do a speed test really quick, and we will get our answer if I'll perform a speed test. Alright, so here you can see that we have only 4 Mbps of speed for download, and the same thing gonna be for upload as well. So you can see that I have limited the speed of bandwidth for this Windows 11 PC, and it gonna stay on 5 Mbps from now on. If I want to remove it, or if I want to just simply want to do it for once and I want to release this IP address, simply uncheck this and click on save. You will get the speed back to your device for which you have limited the speed on TP-Link router. I have unchecked that box, and you can see that the speed for this Windows 11 PC working as it was working before. So in future, if you want to limit the speed as per your requirement, then you can simply check this box and click on save, and that device will reserve to that limited speed of internet, and it will not able to consume more speed in future. So that's how you have to do bandwidth control on TP-Link router, or a bandwidth control for a Wi-Fi user connected to your TP-Link router. If you are facing any problem related to your router, Windows 11 PC, Windows 10 PC, or any kind of Android phone problem you're facing, or your any kind of error or the problem you're facing, you can visit to our forum page. It's showing up on your screen right now, and there you can register yourself and add your question, and make sure to add the screenshot of the error message so that we can understand the problem and give you the answer as per the problem you're facing. So that's all for today. Thanks for watching.